It's osobního fakt.
It's like stepping back in time. Even the owner is an antique.
I did go in once, just to see. But I ran right out again because I came face to face with this creepy-looking og woman.
That would be the old man's daughter. He adores her. I can't for the life of me understand why.
You're kidding.
Because it's his daughter.
A man trapped in the past has a fanatical transhumanist for a daughter?
Hello?
I bet Sunday dinner at their house is lots of fun.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine, I said. Matka, I wasn't in the train station when it happened.
Sydney.
No, I don't. The bank is nowhere near the train station. You live in a town with a population of 800 people, but here things are more spread out. I gotta go. Give my best to Tata. Love you. Bye.
No, Mom. No, I didn't get bombed. Please. I don't need money. Mom, please.
After the bombing, the phones were tied up forever. I never got a chance to call my family.
Yeah, they got you back now.
I have the typical Eastern European mother. She's glad about the train station bombing because it gives her an excuse to worry.
That's one way to phrase it. I like how there's actually no clocks that we can see in here. That's a ripoff. I wanted to talk to this guy.
You see all kinds of unusual people in the city. Sometimes I wonder what their stories are. I bet there are things in your biography that would scare me to death.
Yeah, that's a very true point.
I cannot handle any more of this.
I don't. Are you talking about your food?
That kind of thing.
I mean, that doesn't look delicious at all. What is that supposed to be? You just slap on a little leaf, a little piece of cabbage or lettuce, some tomatoes, and you call that lunch?
Everything is just so dreary. We have forgotten how to enjoy life. You will see people flocking to bars more and more.
Naturals are so fucking weird. Whoa, hold up. Keep your eyes. Just give them a hand. That's an amusing one. But, dude, having augmented eyeballs would be awesome. Adam Jensen has a natural HUD.
Die when you see my new car.
If I had a fucking GPS built into my head, that would be awesome. All right, let me stop digging around with talking with every single person I find. I would like to talk to a couple of people. What do we got? Seek out Laborio. Mark that down, there we go.
Wonderful.
He owns this magic shop. Ah.
I couldn't believe it. He just reached into his wallet, it threw his fake arms and pulled it out like everything was fine.
The last bank to give Ox credit stopped doing it 4 months ago. Where has this guy been?
I don't know. Living in the past? Living in the night? They're all half crazy anyway.
I hate the naturals.
Go away, please. I have to limit my exposure to Ogs for insurance purposes. You have no idea what it's like being a PR rep for the Palisade Bank in this war zone of a city.
You're a PR rep for a bank? Man, wouldn't it be a shame if something terrible happened to you?
I sell designer clothes. You could use some help with your personal style, but you don't meet our standard of clientele. Your shades are okay. Whoever designed those had some talent.
Oh, thank you. She just gets immediately down to drinking. What's going on in this shop? Hi.
Hey there. You looking for a new stereo system?
I don't really get much time to listen to music.
How about movies? You like movies? Or maybe you got other interests?
What do you mean other interests?
What do you mean by other interests?
Well, I figure a man like you, he might need a little energy boost from time to time.
You're not talking about protein bars, are you?
Biocells, my friend. In perfect working order. And completely under the radar.
No, I'm good. I don't really need biocells. Tell me about the movies.
What kind of movies are we talking about?
Oh, never mind. I was just making a stupid joke.
Aw.
What you really mean is you don't want to tell me, since it's obvious I didn't come here for that. Calm down. I'm not a cop.
I mean, I am working with Interpol, though.
I think I'll be on my way.
Feel free to come back if you change your mind.
I want to see what kind of movies y'all have in the future. With that said, I'm gonna turn these off.
Can you say something?
Some of these are gonna be really annoying to deal with, but I can turn them off and I get XP along the way. That's funny. I'll deal with you in a sec. There we go. No more TVs! I have turned them all off. You are not allowed to listen to that lady anymore. She's not really evil, she's just...
This is Eliza Kassan,
morally bankrupt. From Pikus. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Anonymity. Security.
Alright, what's down here anyways? We have... Oop, breach software, that's good. And that's really about it! Alright, let's get some hack going on.
Anomaly detected.
Oh, Jesus.
Trace program initiated.
Oh wait, I didn't start the hack on this one! Oh, thank God! I didn't realize. Hacking is just a lot of me clicking and spamming C for capture. So, I didn't really register that until almost it was too late. Whew! Hello, friends! You are all cordially invited to the Tube House for a screening of a solar-masked Cyborg O. A tale of a man re-engineered to cause havoc on the world, only to turn against his own creators for the good of mankind. Bionic arms, legs, the whole thing, but all used in the name of justice. There's even a part where he kicks some anthropomorphic monster thing and it explodes! How cool is that? Between us, I acted out in the store when the rest of the staff leaves for the night. I have an old optical disc reader that's a decade or two old, but still functional. It should be able to read these discs I had to smuggle in from overseas. The code to get in is 0701. I like the sound of that. Alright, what about this? Instant messaging autosave. Shepard, how long are you gonna keep hiding it? Well, it is cold outside. You have augmentations. Why conceal it? You know how things are. Shit got tense after the incident. I don't want some wacko mob thrashing our place. I guess so. That's a fair way to see it. Plus, on the cool part, it's like I'm one of those cyborg heroes with a hidden identity. For the love of God, Percival. You can't see it, but I'm acting out a change pose right now. Just bring milk when you get home. From Percy Butler to Percy Butler. I want to hear more about what's going on here, because this has my interest, Shepard. Obviously, this isn't the Shepard that had his neck snapped at the beginning of the game. Alright. So where is this again? Invitation to night show. To the Tube House. I don't know where that is exactly. Is there... Oh, it's here. There's something here in this general area. Maybe upstairs. Maybe there's a second floor. 0701. Huh?
This is why I wanted to be a cop.
I feel like maybe there's something up here. Hi, everybody.
A customer. Welcome. You are still deciding. Come back later.
No, I want some H2O boost. It doesn't have to feel like you're a broken machine. That's a fucking awful marketing thing, too. I didn't say it earlier, but that is terrible. You shouldn't market to people that they might be broken.
How come
these people are really disconnected. Oh, you deactivate the car.
Can't take that kickback.
Nice coat.
Waiting next report.
And there's nothing in there. Okay. I just wanted to see what we got. Ooh.
Don't do anything.
This is a big building. What's it for? It's a 33 Hilvani Apartments. Neat. And there's another shop up here.
What is this?
I can open up the locked up windows. Oh, that's great. Oh, I love hacking. Alright, let me actually get this mission started.
I can help you with something. Yes.
Whoa. Yes. I'm not fucking paying you 250 credits. Get the fuck out of here.
I can help you with something. Yes.
Okay, I thought that maybe he was hypnotizing me with yes. But it just made his voice weird after I pressed my vision.
I'm looking for Laborio.
It is me. You have come for the magic?
I'm hoping you can help me make sense of something. A strange encounter I had. A man hiding behind a screen in the sewer, surrounded by followers of some kind. His name is Richard. You used to be partners.
Richard is alive. You found him?
I'm not sure what I found, but I know I didn't like it. Richard had a way of depriving me. Things I wanted to say and do, but I couldn't.
I am so happy he is alive. Richard and I, I was sure that he... I should have known. Richard always said the show must go on.
There was nothing entertaining about this. What is he doing down there? How is he doing it?
I have not seen Richard in many years. We developed a show together. The evolution of stage hypnosis intensified through technology. Adapted versions of the Casey and DDE designs.
A social augmentation?
In conjunction with modern hypnotic techniques, something much more powerful than mere persuasion. The communal construction of an alternate reality. For 3 hours on a Friday night, we guided people into brave new worlds.
These worlds you and Richard created through hypnosis, what were they exactly?
They were whatever people wanted, created together with the audience. Every night was different. After the incident, we were made to stop, treated as criminals. It was not right. People paid for their tickets and embarked on imaginative explorations. We did not hurt anyone. We would never hurt anyone.
I'm not sure that's still true for Richard. His audience now, I'm worried they may be trapped. Is that something he could be capable of? Creating a world and keeping people there indefinitely?
It depends on the personality. If someone is susceptible to the message, and if Richard keeps repeating it, it is conceivable.
Yeah, he's definitely repeating it down there. It seems like he's gonna be on like a 24/7, hey. Why don't you not think about things, guys? All right, good job, Pavel. Good job, Marcus. Okay.
The technology Richard is using to do all this, how does it work?
Binaural beats. Richard bounces his source transmission through a series of emitters that use targeted neural oscillation to stimulate specific areas of the basal ganglia.
Right. Let's assume I'm not familiar with that particular ganglia.
Richard is using a system of emitters that can intensify and adjust his frequency, his message, his intent. Imagine it. He can make the very soul of a transmission pierce into the brainwaves of his target audience.
I don't need to imagine it. I already know it's terrifying.
Yeah, we did see a couple things on the ceilings that were emitting a lot of sound. But I just thought they were just standard alarm things because there was light coming from them as well and it was rotating. Maybe those are the emitters.
Why do you think Richard is doing this? What's his endgame in trying to hypnotize people in a sewer?
I cannot say for sure, but after the incident, after the way things began to change, Richard said he was going to find a better place. I did not hear from him again. The loss of so many people that we knew, I believe it broke him.
He didn't seem very broken to me. More like a guru of some kind, with way too much control over the people in that room.
No, Richard is not capable of hurting anyone. At least, he was not before. He was an idealist, the kind of man who... The worlds we created together on stage, they were more beautiful than the reality.
Well, to be fair, he's not really hurting these people directly. He's just holding them against their will, and they don't know it because of the way he's doing it.
Tell me how to stop Richard.
Richard is conveying a vision of himself, of themselves, of an alternate community they are building together. If it is Richard's goal to keep the people there, the only way to free them is to make them see through it.
Well, how do I do that? Last time I talked to him, it didn't go so well.
The signal he is transmitting, its effect is limited to a specific radius. To the room where the audience is, where the emitters are installed. Wherever Richard is must be outside of that room.
So if I get to him, I'll be able to say or do whatever I want?
Yes. But promise you won't hurt him. Please.
I'm not promising anything. Something tells me if I do get in there, he's not going to be content to just talk.
There may be a better way. The emitters, they are somewhere in the room, yes? Okay then, so wait. You wait. Just wait 1 second, please. Wait for it. Wait for it. Where are you? Come. Come to me. Shh. Pa, 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 pa. Wait.
You know, you don't have to say wait. You can just look for it and not have to worry about me judging you.
I am looking for. I think I have found what you need. Ta-da!
EMP mines? Oh.
They are scrambling devices.
Scrambling
our
devices.
Safe whenever things got ugly. Attach them to the emitters and it closes the ability to amplify. Good night. Show's over. Your gods are but men again.
And that'll be enough to make the people in the room see through them?
I hope. If they have been exposed for a very long time, you need to help them to see. But please be kind to Richard. I don't know what he has become, but I know what he was. A decent man once, who simply believed that the world should be better.
We all believe that. But there are better and worse ways of going about it.
Okay, thank you for that. All right, I just have to go back to the last district, plant some emitter-canceling things. I know exactly what I gotta do.
You know exactly what you need to do.
Yeah. Don't you repeat what I was saying back to me. That's fucking creepy. Why should I refrain from doing that? Are you hiding things down here? You didn't do a good job of stopping me, did you? What do we got? Wine. I see there's an entire room behind here. Oh, whoa, hello. Why do you have all this? My sweet Libario, for the authorities to have canceled our show was humiliating, but to see our friends in prison because they are different, to watch as our inventions, our life's work, get confiscated and destroyed? I know you are not easily outraged. You will find a way to adapt to this new world. You will compromise. Does this make you a better man than me, or does it make you worse? Regardless, you know the community initiative was never about magic and entertainment for me. It was about alternatives, about creating places together, or about creating places people could escape to. The hours we spent crafting worlds together were the happiest of my life. I intend to extend them into eternity. Libario, you knew about this shit already. What the fuck, dude? He didn't mention anything about getting this message. That's not cool, man. It's really not good. But okay, alright, we can accept that, and maybe these vents can lead me to other areas. Holy shit, this is a long one. What? Okay. Nope, this is the same one from the other area. I was figuring, hey, here's a newspaper that we didn't read beforehand. We're good. I still want to see what the hell the code is for the tube house. I didn't actually find it. Maybe I never had to find it. Maybe I already hacked the thing myself. Is that all you got? No, we got this other entrance over here that maybe leads into another basement. Just leads out the street. Hello, everybody! No, I'm not traveling to Precasa. Just yet.
You know exactly what you need to do.
I can't confront him about this? Man, that's a shame. Anyways, I feel like I'm probably gonna have to accumulate a few missions before I go back and do anything else. Validate the permits? Oh, yeah! How am I gonna get about this? So I have to infiltrate the government building, access the computer, slap in a couple of codes, and then we'll be good. But I need to figure out how to get into there without having a lot of trouble. Oh boy.
permit validation office is closed. It's always closed.
Okay. Well, there's got to be a way to get in there somehow. Like, maybe I can jump from here to here. I'm good. But it looks like there is no way for me to get over this wall. Damn. It won't let me climb it. I was hoping I was onto something. Okay. Nope. I gasped for nothing. I was like, oh, look, a secret way. And then I realized, nope, I just came back the same exact area. Well, I could knock them out. The problem is the camera will see them, probably. It's gotta be a way. Usually a vent or something that leads into the area, or another window for me to go through. Let me use one of these biocells so I can keep on running around without worry. Biocell! I have 18 of them! Aha! Found a vent! Alright. Just had to search around for a while. Whoops. I'm not jumping that high. The fuck?
Augmentations are not authorized in this area.
Soon enough.
I don't think it matters what's authorized and what's not. I just want to get inside this vent. Oh, there we go. That was fucking weird. I was holding space to jump higher and higher, but it wasn't working. Alright, I'm gonna make the immediate assumption that, this is gonna take me to where I need to go. I do not have the code for this terminal, so we're just gonna have to hope for the best. Oh boy.
Trace program initiated.
Shit, I'm going the wrong way!
Access granted.
Okay, we're good. Camera's off. And then what about the permit station? Activate. Oh no, wait. Mist devices? What the hell are these things? Whoa. Ah, the registry stations themselves! For me to access and tool around with. Wait, they just turned off. No, come back! It's temporarily on. Here.
Milena, I got into the AUG permit registry.
Hold on. That should give me access now as well.
Why am I seeing a security timer?
Probably because neither of us have done this before. Cross your fingers. I borrowed this employee ID from a guy in a bar.
Holy shit, that's a long employee number.
Why does it say there's only one validation slot?
Shit! The city has quotas for this kind of thing. Prague is designed to regulate people to death.
What does that mean?
The system won't let this guy register two people. Just scan something. There isn't much time. Help one person at least.
Oh shit. 12 seconds to decide? Fuck, I don't remember. Just Irenka.
Good. Irenka's documents should hold up to any kind of scanning check now. She's as legit as she can be. Without actually being legit.
I came here to help two people.
It doesn't always work that way. Look, you need to get out of there. Please.
Milena, that permit I wasn't able to scan. What happens to Edward now?
He probably ends up in Golem. Or he gets arrested for trying to use fake documentation. Thrown into a cell somewhere. I don't know. Doesn't exactly feel like a win, does it?
No, it doesn't.
It feels like
we
a cheap ripoff.
We did the best we could. Listen, thanks for being one of the good guys.
It feels like one of those game concessions where it's just like, oh, you could only help one or the other. Ha! Doesn't that make you feel bad? Because in real life, you can't help out everybody. Fuck that! Fuck you, game. Well, I... If I can make any justification, Edward... If he's taken to Gollum City, he'll be with his family, who are in Gollum City. So, while Gollum City sucks, it works out for him. Whereas with Erika, whatever, I don't think she really had any benefit to go into Gollum City, just pure negatives.
If you're hoping to buy something from me, you're out of luck.
Why? What if I need some exterminating done?
I'm closed right now, sorry.
Fine, God, I'll just go sneak around in the vents. Because that's a thing I like to do. It leads me to places. Nope, this one doesn't really get me anywhere decent. I mean, this isn't a restricted office just yet. Okay, let's see if there's anything in this trunk. Ooh, beer. Alright, I'm gonna check out this police truck. There was nothing in it! I hacked it for nothing! It makes me sad.
Hey!
Go away! This is crazy. I'm nervous about leaving the main street because I'm afraid of getting attacked.
If it's any consolation, the smaller streets are less likely to get hit by a terrorist bomb because they have less people.
That is not a consolation.
It isn't.
Are you trying to make me afraid all the time?
I'm sorry. I didn't do it on purpose. I'm afraid all the time too.
Thank you.
I don't care what your cause is. I'm not interested.
You're not even caring if I'm trying to save the world! Oh, hey! Build your burger. Oh, I wanna fucking build a burger! Crap, I'm hungry. I haven't had lunch today. They've got ice cream sandwich. This is like...
Luckily, I brought the right tools.
This is like a McDonald's. Order here, and then maybe a robot makes it.
The world is dirty. That's why I clean. It is a calling, I suppose. I have work to do.
I mean, you're a janitor, but you're kind of...
Looks simple enough.
Acting more like a technician here.
Life can be so confusing. People are searching for answers everywhere. The answers are right in front of you. You just have to clean up the mess first.
Okay, well... That would still be a good reason to be confused. If you can't see it clearly, of course you're gonna be confused. You could have everything laid out in front of you, but if it's buried under a bunch of muck, you just might not notice forever. It sucks sometimes. I want to enter all these, like, fucking high-tech bars and shit playing music. Do I have any other missions out here at the moment? I could run into the apartments. Lord knows we're probably gonna get something in there. But let's check out this garden place first. Oh, this is just a salad bar area.
I got the right to refuse service to anyone. I do not do business with clicks.
Hey, augmented people need food too? You gonna order something or are you just gonna stare at the salad?
Listen to that garbage.
I am sure your credits are good. It is the principle. If a person has no principles, they have nothing.
I would love to hear some of these people explain away the bullshit that they have going on with them. Right? I mean, it's 2029. So, 15 years from now... Alright, well, actually, wait, hold up, I got fucking numbers mixed up. About 13 years from now, you'll have people just being like, I don't serve people like you. Why? We already deal with that shit, well, not only in the past, but currently, just get the fuck over it. At least you could go, I don't trust you because you might punch me in the face and kill me. And then I go, okay, fair enough. And if you were to punch me, I'd be pretty screwed. And you're like, yeah. Yeah, augmented fists do hurt quite a bit. I'll give you credit on that, but otherwise, no. It'd be ridiculous. Whoa, I can turn off stuff through walls? Oh, this hack augment is great. I just need to upgrade it to deal with, like, lasers and shit. Hello? This is a really nice looking apartment. Oh, he's even got a hidden... a hidden safe. Well, isn't that something? Let's hack it. Alright. So the fastest way for me to hack everything would be... to go this way. Ooh, look at all these detections.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
I can do it! I just have to hope this speeds the fuck up! Oh boy!
Access granted.
Now we're good. Hi, hidden safe. What do we got in you? Oh, confidential medical report? What? What?! Confidential medical report containing Adam Jensen's medical history?! What the fuck?! I'm obviously in a place I'm in a little bit early on. Why does this person have a medical report about me? Oh shit. Who the fuck does this place belong to? Madame Photographe? Oh shit. That's not good. That's not good. We can't. That's not good. We can't trust this place at all.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Oh, I gotta go a far way. Nuke! Just save me the trouble! Okay. We received your last surveillance package and are running down the unknowns in the photographs. If anything pertinent hits, we will update you with required actions. In the meantime, keep trailing the girl and the watcher will handle the main subject. Am I the main subject? I've been asked to return to Prague to evaluate assets. With regards to the main subject, in particular, I'll need medical records, reports, everything as recent as possible. You'll have to ask the watcher for those, I'd imagine. Once you have them, leave them somewhere safe. As always, the storage unit is my preference. Then clean the apartment and get yourself a hotel. Also, the refrigerator is to be stocked with an assortment of organic juices, and there should be fresh fruit. All this goddamn travel is drying me out. Okay. So... somebody is trailing me, and possibly Alex as well. Oh, shit. You know what? I don't care if all this travel's drying you out. Screw your hydration and everything else. Whoops. The refrigerator was thrown out. Who the fuck are these people? It's a good thing they got themselves into a hotel. But that was a hell of a random discovery. That's so sketchy. I'm really worried. I can't believe I just stumbled across really heavy story info like that.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Ah, shit, I am super far away from where I need to go. Nuke it!
Access granted.
The nuke is the emergency button, man. Nuke is the emergency button. Jesus. Is this gonna be all about me? There's a limb clinic somewhere around at the top area? So maybe not. Maybe just people tracking general information. I just find this super suspicious. I mean, a ton of pictures and camera equipment, a gun next to a place that also had a ton of cameras. But was used for tracking me? Oh! Not happy about the current situation.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Does hacking stuff increase? Oh, jeez.
Access granted.
Does hacking stuff increase the reinforcements to these areas, or is it just because of the firewall reaching to them, or the trace reaching them? I hope it's the trace. Because I saw some of them start going plus one, but I wasn't paying complete attention because I was busy spamming capture on everything. What do we got? We have a crafting parts box down here. Ooh, pocket secretary, this could be useful. Come on, get out of the screen, credits. I know I got credits. There we go. Son of a gun, duh. No need for help, shit's still coming through from the PCR. It's just getting hard to keep the same volume. Trust me, I'm doing what I can. What's good about this Kosinski guy in Warsaw is he always says they're seeing a lot of older military hardware too, which can still be interesting as well as the usual. Arrangement stays the same. If I get to the locker before the weekend, I'll leave you some stuff to look through. Alright, what's going through here? Subject, two things. One, good job. Warsaw, I'll let Raditz know. We'll still be moving weapons from the Prague cops too, though, right? That arrangement is powering more than a few handshakes, so we need to know if there's gonna be a problem. Do we need another middleman to help out, or are you good? Two, Yefim set out a second VIP in the Palisade using 0411. So any credit drops or bonus prizes need to go in that one from now on. You know, I think that's the second thing we've heard about being stored at the Palisade Bank. I need to head there sometime soon and cash in on the things that these people are missing out on. Ooh, a free laser sight! And a shotgun! That's another intense thing. What do I want to put my laser sight on? I could probably put the laser sight on my pistol or my stun gun, but I don't really need to do that exactly. You know, I want to try something out. Okay. I'm going to slap the laser sight onto my sniper rifle or my trank gun. Will that... That's going to be really beneficial. I mean, I should also get a laser sight in general. But this makes it so I can aim this in close range as well as long range if I need to. The thing with a stun gun is that it's generally always going to be a close range weapon. So I don't really need to slap a laser sight onto it. Of course, it'll help to hip fire. I'm sure I'll get another laser sight at some point or buy one. But I think the laser sight will benefit my trank gun needs. Because if I have the trank gun out by accident or something like that, that'll be good. Or if I just want to dick around and be like, oh, look, a guy over there. Boop. And he's gone. Okay. I accidentally unbound that. What is going on through this vent? I am not entirely sure, but I see there's a wall that we can punch. I will punch it soon. I just want to see if there's anything up here. Come on, there's gotta be something. Here we go. Crafting parts. I'm fine with that. And maybe some neuroprazine? No, just some biocell and credit chips. That's fine too. I do like money. And it looks to be about it. Alright, let's punch the vent. The really big one. Wait, where is this going? Oh, TF20. I just broke into my own workplace. That's funny. He's like, wait, what the fuck? Why is there someone back there? I might need to break into my own workplace because I do have to plant my listening chip at some point. Main missions. Go to the TF-29's office. I was caught off guard by Yessi's attack. I suspect I'm not the only task force who was blindsided by it. I need to report to our offices in the Chesta district and find out why. I probably should chat up with them before I go back to the other district. But I'm starting to fill up on so many things. I mean, look at my inventory. I only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 slots available. That's not good. Actually, 8. 8. I need to sell some stuff. And store things. I don't really need the tactical shotgun, I don't need the combat rifle, because again, I have some in storage. So I can sell these to whatever vendor sells weapons. Don't know where those are. Although there is a vendor in the apartments that I wanted to check out, so I'm gonna head over there. Maybe they also have people who buy weapons. Like my apartments. Hello. It must be hard for you. The city was never kind, but now, I don't know how you do it. I like this guy. I was gonna make fun of his appearance, because, let's be honest, this looks like a really pretentious looking outfit. This scarf, and this... whatever the fuck, really? Zippers on your back? Are you a Final Fantasy or Kingdom Hearts character? I've noticed that some parts of the town are better than others. Good luck. Yeah, yeah, you're in the better part, don't worry, so you got that covered. Jim Miller, Michael Mendel, Evan Pribble, P.I.P.Y. Nevitat. Actually, wasn't there an apartment over here that we had to check out? I think it was 302. I am super intrigued.
What did you do that for? I am protecting the real people in the building. And most of them on that list are a few months late with their rent anyway.
Okay, there's a lot that we can do here. I can break in through the windows. I'm probably not going to. I can still hack them though. Just in case. I could come through the windows. It would save me all this hacking information stuff. I still want to hack because XP! And also sometimes extra items. I'm trying to be cautious here. Now this is a pretty suave part of town. So I would wager that they would have a lot of stuff going on here. Also, I like these apartments. This is a really cool fucking bathroom. This is like an entire little room by itself. You even have a couch, or a lot of the couch, a bench to sit on. If you want to just treat it like a sauna. Dude! Whoever has this fucking apartment, they might not be like super rich, but damn! I would love a place like this! Chill on the sauna after, like, some exercise or something, and then way the fuck over here you have the world's furthest away fucking toilet. So you don't have to worry about it super contaminating the entire bathroom. Two sinks. Although, is there more than one bedroom here? Oh, fuck, I opened the door. I didn't mean to do that. My hacking and experience, man, no. They're gonna come back and be like, what happened? And it could turn out someone broke into this place. All right. Mr. Pribble, I now have clear information on what has happened. In a recent raid upon the offices of the Foundation for Augmented Advancement, an activist and fundraising organization with ties to ARC and other suspected terrorist organizations, the state police discovered your parents' name among the regular contributors. For this reason, both Mr. and Mrs. Pribble have been summarily deported to the Unilek complex and are unable to leave due to the legal restrictions on augmented individuals in place by the authorities in Prague. By law, the property of terrorist colluders is subject to full seizure. Although I have managed to obtain a moratorium on the confiscation of your parents' condominium and most of its contents, namely for the sake of your sister, Natasha. With no surviving family on your father's side and close relatives on your mother's side being currently untraceable, you are considered to assume the role of Natasha's legal guardian if mutual agreement is established. On your parents' behalf, I am instructed to ask you to leave your studies and return to Chechkia. To take care of her. In the event of you becoming your sister's legal guardian, the condominium and its associated storage locker, code 2913, remain in your possession until your sister's 14th birthday, or until your parents' official release from Gollum, whichever comes sooner. Since you have no legal claim to the condominium, in the event you move out before the end of the moratorium period, it could and may be seized immediately by the state as an abandoned property. As has become increasingly common with Udalek, I have been unable to contact your parents since their deportation to the complex. The authorities assure me all is well. Should you continue to return to Prague, you have 1 week to make your decision and return to occupy the condominium. Otherwise, all property will be confiscated immediately, and your sister will become a ward of the state. Please let me know your decision as soon as possible. Jesus Christ. And then we have this one. Subject: my life feels like it has exploded. Pete, you've probably heard there was another bombing in Prague. Me and Nat are fine, but the city is trying out a new system where after a terrorist attack, all the schools move to stadiums, and the kids camp out there for a week out under the protection of soldiers or something. It might be the National Guard, but I don't know. Even the police look military strength. It seems pretty extreme to me, but everything is these days. At least it keeps the parents from freaking out, which is why I'm writing. For the first time since I moved here, I'm alone with no one to worry about me. And as soon as that hit me, I felt so relieved, I almost felt like crying. Actually, I did. There's no point pretending I'm okay with this. No exaggeration. Pete, I have no idea what I'm doing here. Sometimes I think it would be better for Nat if I let her go to a foster home. Those people want to be parents, and they know what they're doing. Meanwhile, I keep hoping that someone at school is going to tell her about periods so I don't have to. She's only 10, for God's sake. I'm freaking out. I don't even know what to do. Evan. Poor Evan. Okay. I broke into this dude's apartment. And I'm taking all of his stuff after all the terrible shit that's happened to him. Oops. I didn't even read this. Holy crap. Update on your parents' property safe. Mr. Pribble, thank you for your recent communication. On behalf of the Palisade Property Bank, I'd like to extend our sympathies for your situation. We can confirm that we've already established contact with your father's attorney and conducted the necessary steps to include you as an interim legal account holder. Under the terms of the VIP account terms and condition, you are entitled to proxy control of said box until your parent's situation is legally resolved. When you come to the bank, we can help by offering some time with a Palisade representative that can explain how the bank works and what you need to know for interacting with our services. The code for your parents' security allocation is 0310. Aside from any persons your parents may have advised, you are the only other person outside of the bank who is aware of your parents' relationship with Palisade, including any and all governmental authorities. We at Palisade Bank pride ourselves on preserving the privacy of our clients. We look forward to meeting you, and thank you for being a customer with the Palisade Property Bank. Where the fuck is this bank? I can't look at it right now. Because we're in this apartment. Crap. Showing map. No, I'm not trying to go here. No, it's just trying to show me the entrance or the exit out of here. Damn it. The few times the map really screws with us. Okay, oh shit, that's not good. The vent is electrified? Oh no. Let's make a full save here. Get something. So I assume that either the guy moved out of here to stay with his sister, his little sister, or he's just currently out of the house right now. Either way, this is a really nice place, just in general. I'd love a place like this. I just love modern architecture, just like really cool looking places. This is a fantastic bathroom. You know, minus the fact that it's excessive in size. Absolutely. Dude, this place is bigger than my room. My bedroom here that I'm currently sitting in is smaller than this bathroom. At least lengthwise. I don't know about actual square foot. Alright, I'm going through the vent above the bathroom. It'll hopefully lead me into another apartment or into a backspace. Ow, 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 ow. Oh hey, he's got a television in his bathroom. I turned that off, but I didn't realize it. Jesus Christ. Dude, it'd be awesome to have a bath. And then have a TV in the bathroom too. Cause then you could just chill out and watch like a really awesome movie while having a bubble bath or something. That'd be nice. That'd be pleasant. Alright. I'm just gonna jump to the other side here. Save myself some trouble. Of going through the vents.
Psychotic killing spree is causing the greatest loss of life in recent history.
Oh, we already learned about that.
I cannot speak for you folks, but
I'm gonna walk into one of these places one day and there's gonna be a person inside. And they're gonna be like, what are you doing here? And we actually have a conversation about it. Alright. Private mailing group, invitation to tonight's show. Hello, friends. You are all cordially invited to the Tube House for a screening of Solar Mask. Oh. This guy also got a show invite. I need to head over to the Tube House again sometime and eventually find what the hell I'm looking for. This is also a nice place. I don't know if their bathroom is fancy. Hold up. Nope, their bathroom is super fancy too, Jesus. So they're pretty much the same, but slightly different in terms of layout of everything. And that makes me appreciate that. I'm so glad everybody has windows that are unlocked. Because it's one thing to hack open something or turn off something with hacks. But these are legitimately unlocked windows and shit like that. I mean, I don't imagine people expect people to come in through second or third story window. But I keep all my shit locked anyways. I just don't trust it. Whoa! Fucking acceleration speed came along again. I guess it happened when I touched this little ledge here. That is weird. A nice bathroom as well. This one is a little colder feeling, though. I can't break through up there. And this guy has an upstairs area. I'm checking it out. Hold up. Aww, what a nice little family they got going on here. Do all of them live here? That's actually a good question. You show two fathers and their kids. But we only have a bed for, well, the fathers. This could be one of those, like, side-off apartments, though. So they live with their kids somewhere else. But occasionally come back here to chill out. You know, do a little bit of working out in front of everybody. Or I miss something. Look, either the kids sleep on the fucking couch. Or this place does not suit a family. Alright, let's check out this vent up here. Have to open it with a jump, and then finally we can actually jump in. So I'm assuming this leads to another apartment that is also really sizable with two stories. God!
Human presence ow. Detected. Engaging smart home system. Smart system engaged. Scanning bio data.
Uh-oh.
Unauthorized presence confirmed. Intruder protocols engaged.
What?
You are not the authorized homeowner. Your presence in this home is not certified.
What are you gonna do about it, smart home system?
Please vacate the premises.
Are you gonna shoot me? Cause you can't. I'm gonna take the beer.
You have chosen not to leave. Please confine yourself to a corner and wait for local authorities to arrive.
Oh shit, guards are actually coming over here. Uh-oh. I gotta get out of here as soon as possible. Shit. What's even up here? Is it worth it?
Safety is the primary concern.
All I've found so far in this apartment is money. Oh, shit! There's a dead person in here! Oh, God. I hear bad things about Neon. I don't think it's as harmless as people say. Please, Ayanka, just because you get invited somewhere doesn't mean you have to go. Panther! Oh god. Lady, I don't know what happened here. I don't know if I can ever find out what happened to you. I'm worried. Okay. Alright. They almost saw me completely while getting in the vent. We're good though. That was worrisome. I was not expecting a smart home system to be the one thing that gets me detected in this place. More people need that! Because Lord knows I'm just rummaging through all their shit just because I went through a window. That's another thing these guys need. Alarm systems. But to be fair, this is an apartment complex. I don't know the laws behind slapping in more alarm systems. That one guy had it though, so good on him.